I'm so sorry, girlfriend. You're awesome. I love you so much. I'm in love. No, no, no. Hello. Welcome back to my channel. Thank you so much for being here. That was super sweet of you. Oh my gosh, my nose ring is itchy. Something they don't tell you about having a fake septum piercing is how much it's going to tickle your little nose hairs. I know, big spoiler for those of you who thought this was a real nose ring the whole time. I'm a fraud. What can I say? This is not real. But as I used to mention literally all the time in all of my videos, because I'm very defensive about it, I used to have my nose pierced, and if you look really close, if you look like up close and personal at my nose, see, there's a little hole right there. I know it's not a septum piercing, but I did used to have my nose pierced. I got it pierced at a place in New Jersey that did not do it in a very sanitary way, and I got a big infection, so I had to take it out. But you know what? You live, you learn, and you go on to see another day. But that's not what this video is about. You did not click on this video to find out that my nose ring is not real, but I used to have my nose pierced. No, you clicked on this video because you, like me, have an interest in makeup products that I underestimated. So I got this idea the other day because I was using one of these products, and I was just like, man, if you had told me 2 months ago that I was going to fall in love with this product the way that I did, I would not have believed you. And of course, as makeup consumers, you know, we don't like to buy products that we don't think we're gonna like, and that's never my intention when buying products because I do not like to waste my money. But you know, sometimes you buy things in the Sephora sale section and you do have that thought in the back of your mind, like, why did they end up here? Why would they end up in the sale section? Not just like, oh, the brand is having a sale. They went to the sale section, you know? I feel like that's a different vibe altogether then. So a lot of these products I got from the sale section that ended up being hidden gems. And then I also have a couple of other products that were sent to me that I fully did not expect to like. So you know what? We're all about the underdog proving us wrong on this channel, and I'm so excited to introduce you to these underdog makeup products that I underestimated. So if that sounds like a topic that is interesting to you and you like finger guns and you want to hear about products that I underestimated, then I encourage you to please subscribe and keep on watching. It's coming at you right now. Alrighty, so the first product I want to talk to you about is one of those examples of a product that I got at the Sephora sale section and I probably never would have bought if it wasn't on sale, and that is the Fenty Mademoiselle lipstick. I have the shade Saucy, which is a beautiful, fiery, vibrant orange. I'm gonna swatch it for you right now because, oh my freaking gosh, I mean, it's just so beautiful. So these are actually still on sale at the Sephora sale section. I got this like a year ago. They're still somehow on sale, but I believe when Fenty launched these in 2018, editing me, correct me if I'm wrong, but when Fenty launched these, they launched a ton of shades of these Mademoiselle lipsticks. It's supposed to be a matte bullet lipstick, and there was a lot of hype around them, and not long after, they ended up in the sales section. So me, in my little Keebler elves brain, you know, the Keebler elves in my brain are running around making cookies, burning them in wheelbarrows, but they're saying to themselves, those aren't good. Those aren't good. That's why they ended up in the sales section. Why would they be in the sales section if they were good? But despite my brain thinking this way, I still bought one because I was like, you know what? It was on sale. It was like $9. I was already making a Sephora order, and I think they were having like their VIB sale or whatever. So I grabbed one, and I'm so glad that I did because this has no business being in the sales section. Am I thrilled it's in the sales section? Absolutely I am. I love a sweet deal. But this is an awesome product. I have no idea why it went on sale so much. Do I think the original price tag of like $19, $18 is a bit much? Yeah, I certainly do. That's way too much. But for $9, this is a steal. This is a wonderful, wonderful lipstick formula, and I have no idea why it ended up in the sales section. I mean, I already showed you the color. You can see how beautiful the color is. But did you also see that swipe? Did you see how creamy that is? I mean, you hear matte Moiselle, and you assume it's going to be matte. It's going to be drying, right? I've tried matte bullet lipsticks before that were no thank you, get out of here and don't come back. This is not one of those matte lipstick formulas. You know what? In every single video I say I'm not gonna swatch every lip product that I talk about, and in every single video I end up swatching it anyways because I really feel like you need to see this applied on my lips. Ooh, let me zoom in. Okay, so I just wiped off a tinted lip oil that I had on before, but my lips are dry right now. There's nothing to prep them for this matte lip product, and look at how creamy and smooth it applies. Look at that. I mean, come on. I don't know how much that shows you, but I feel like, I hope this is showing you how creamy it is and how pigmented and beautiful but not patchy at all it is. I mean, this formula is just beautiful. Look at this. You couldn't do that with a not creamy matte lip product. Look at my lips. Swiping them around like this. I mean, it's creamy as heck. Creamy, 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 but gives a matte look to it. Feels so, so good. I can move my lips around. They don't feel crusty. They don't get gross looking throughout the day. And I did not expect this to be so good when I ordered it. Again, I got it in the sales section at Sephora. A lot of the products in the sales section at Sephora are big old duds. So I did not have high hopes for this. I only bought it because it was on sale. And I was like, well, even if the formula sucks, I really like the color. So I'll just like make it work and mix it with other things. But I don't have to mix it with other things. I don't need to add an oil to make this feel comfortable. It's already comfortable, but looks matte. I mean, I truly feel like this is an underrated product at Sephora for sure. Again, it's still in the sales section. If you've been curious about it, but you weren't sure how the formula was gonna be because it's been in the sales section for so long and I feel like you don't hear people talk about it a lot, get it anyways, because I promise you the formula is awesome. It's super comfortable. I have super dry skin. My lips tend to be very dry and I did not experience any dryness with this. So yeah, the Fenty Mademoiselle lipstick is definitely a makeup product that I underestimated. All right, let's stay on lips since we know that I'm inevitably gonna end up swatching all of them. And the next lip product that I severely underestimated is the Deck of Scarlet 3-Way Lip Oil. Now, if you're not new to my channel, you're probably like, big hearty eye roll because I talk about these all the time. But you know what? When I find a product that I love, I can't shut up about it because I want you guys to know too. This product fit this category so perfectly because I underestimated the heck out of these guys. Let me wipe off this lipstick so that I can try it on here for you. And what I love so much about these lip oils that I did not expect to love is not only the formula, but the application method. Because I've used lip oils before. Physicians Formula used to have a Muru Muru butter lipstick. They had a lip oil type of thing that was in like their butter formula that I loved, but it melted. The stick melted immediately, not even in hot weather, literally just sitting out on my desk, it melted. I used to have to keep it in the freezer. It was such a hassle and it made me never want to wear it. What I love about these Deck of Scarlet lip oils is that they come in a clicker. You click them down to reveal as much product as you want, and that way it doesn't melt and get everywhere. And also, look at this formula. They call it a 3-way lip oil because you can wear it 3 different ways. You can wear it super sheer, which I'll show you now. We just put on one layer and then you dab it out with your fingers. This is the way I like to wear it the most often, just kind of as a sheer wash of color. But look at how pretty! It feels like a lip mask. Like, I have a couple of lip masks that I like to wear, and this feels exactly like those. It's so, so comfortable. But I did say it's a 3-way lip oil, so I don't really know about the 3-way. It is buildable. That's all the 3-way is to imply, is that it's buildable, because look, I can add a little more, and it becomes more pigmented, but it still stays comfortable, and it still feels very light. So I love that about it, and again, it's just the perfectness of the clicker. The clicker is what really makes this for me. I did not anticipate loving the clickability of it so much. Honestly, when I first saw these, I was like, oh, it's kind of in this like very bland, unassuming black packaging. It doesn't really look all that impressive to me. I was like, what's gonna be different about these, you know, than any other lip oil that I've tried? Well, these are different than any other lip oil that I've tried. They're different from any other lip product that I've tried. If I had to pick a favorite formula for a lip product, I would use the Deck of Scarlet 3-Way Lip Oil as a reference. And I gotta be honest with you, Deck of Scarlet is a brand I didn't really know anything about before they wanted to send me something. I kind of had heard that they were like a subscription brand. I'm gonna be honest, I wasn't really impressed by anything I had seen so far, so I wasn't really ready to be impressed by these. And I was incredibly impressed by them. Still, of everything Deck of Scarlet has sent me, because they have sent me 2 of their other launches, this has been my favorite thing. This has been one of my favorite items I have got this year. This will definitely be featured in a best of 2021 because it is that good, and I just can't believe I underestimated it in such a way. I'm so sorry, girlfriend. You're awesome. I love you so much. Oh, so cute. Oh, I got lip oil on my lip oil. Oh my goodness. Okay, we gotta move on to another product because I've been screaming about this for a while, but the Deck of Scarlet 3-Way Lip Oils were makeup products that I underestimated. All right, the last lip product that I want to talk to you about today. I know, we got a lot of lip products in this category. Here's the thing. With lip products, I do often take a chance on them because I know that I have my own methods for how to make things more wearable, even if they end up not being my favorite formula, you know? And sometimes I won't even use them as lipsticks. Sometimes sometimes I use lipstick as blush, so I'm more willing to take a chance on lipsticks. But little did I know that the chance I would be taking on these Colored Rain liquid lipsticks would be a good chance. It would be Sunny with a Chance, starring Demi Lovato. But these guys didn't get canceled after a couple seasons. These guys have stuck around with me because I just love them so much. I actually got these on sale. I think that was another reason I was willing to take a chance. Are we noticing a pattern here? I'm more willing to try things when they're on sale because I'm a cheap lady. But with the Colored Rain liquid lipsticks, it's not that I didn't expect to like them, it's just that even when I bought these liquid lipsticks, I was not a fan of liquid lipstick. I was like, I don't know, maybe they'll change my mind. I don't know. Well, they did change my mind. So something in my brain must have been predicting the future and knowing that I was gonna like these, because there was no reason for me to like these. Let's try one on so I can show you why I love it so much. The reason I love this Colored Rain liquid lipstick so much is because, much like the Fenty Mademoiselle lipstick, it's not dry and it looks beautiful. Oh my gosh, it's so cushiony and beautiful. I'm gonna use the shade Electric Rain here. It's this beautiful, vibrant red orange. Oh, wait till you see it. Oh my gosh. Look at that one swipe pigment too, my goodness. I mean, this is another situation where it's so lightweight that it's like you barely even feel it on your lips at all. And I was able to apply my whole lips without dipping back in even once, which is really, really amazing. I mean, look at how much I'm moving my lips right now. It is so comfortable to talk in, to move around in. It's a really velvety formula. Ugh, it feels like velvet. It honestly does feel like velvet because it feels like soft on your lips. Like, it doesn't feel dry or crackly at all. Like, you could kiss somebody in these and they wouldn't be like, crusty lips. Because I know there were times back in 2016 where I was wearing like the world's most drying liquid lipstick formula where I would kiss my boyfriend and he was probably like, it's a bit dry. And the sweet dear would certainly never say anything, but I know if I were kissing myself, it'd probably feel a little dry, but these don't feel dry at all. They feel soft and pillowy soft. Ugh, could be a great date lip if you don't know if you're gonna be kissing the person later, but you wanna have something on like just in case and you don't wanna have to worry about reapplying. Colored Rain, they're here for you. They're absolutely here for you. This formula is wonderful. I also have this really fun purple shade called Bodacious that's just like such a fun bold shade and it's so pretty and they're both so good. I just really love the Colored Rain liquid lipstick formula and it's definitely a makeup product that I underestimated. Alrighty, I'm finally ready to move on from lip products. Should we keep this on for the rest of the video? I can't decide if it's clashing. You know what? We're keeping it because you're not here to tell me not to. Let's talk about a foundation that I severely underestimated. And that is the Milk Flex Stick Foundation. If you're not new to my channel, again, you probably big eye roll, like, we get it, you like that foundation. But have you heard the origin story of why I love this foundation so much? No, you haven't, so let's get into it. Last year, I did a video where I was trying some stuff from Milk Makeup for the first time. They were doing an exclusive shade of their Kush Lip Balm last year called Shine, which 100% of the proceeds were going towards The Center, which is an LGBTQ+ organization in New York City. So I was super excited that 100% of the proceeds were going to that, so that made me want to buy it. I grabbed a couple other things, and then they sent me a free sample of their Milk Flex Stick Foundation. It didn't look like this. It was a free sample. It was in a little like tin thing that I had to scoop out with my finger. And I was like, whatever, cool, I'll try it just for the video, whatever. I don't think I'm gonna like it, but who knows? Maybe, who knows? So I put on this foundation and my mind was like sinking out of my ears. Like my mind had exploded. It could not handle how good the foundation looked. I had never used a foundation stick before that didn't suck. The only other one I had used before was from ColourPop. Do you guys even remember the ColourPop foundation sticks? I feel like they tried to sweep that one under the rug because those were drying. They were so, so dry. They made my skin look terrible. It made my skin look cracky, streaky. It just did not work at all. So I was not looking for other foundation sticks. I was like, hey, whoa man, foundation sticks and me just might not be meant to be. You know, I thought maybe I'm too dry for that. So you can imagine my surprise when the Milk Flex foundation stick was like the most hydrating thing in the world and like literally feels like you're putting skincare on your skin because it's so emollient and creamy and yet it's not like tacky and sticky and it's not too dewy. It's like your skin with serum on. That's what it looks like. I'm wearing it today. I will admit, it. I have it mixed with my First Aid Beauty Ultra Repair Tinted Moisturizer because they are a beautiful match together and it gives even more luminosity. But this foundation is just super, super luminous. It just is another one where it's so creamy. I don't know if that shows you anything, but you can kind of see the shift here where it like definitely has a glow to it. It's a glowy foundation, not a shimmery foundation. Really hydrating, but not so dewy that I think it would just like slip right off your skin if you had oily skin. I mean, you might want to set it more than I do because I don't really set the foundation since my skin is so dry. I just set like my under eyes and the center of my face, but I think you could definitely set this. This does set very nicely. So I just think it's a wonderful foundation. I'm always shocked I don't hear more people talk about it because I think it's really, really underrated at Sephora, underrated wherever it's sold. I don't know, you sold anywhere else? I bought it on the Milk website, but the Milk Flex Foundation Stick is definitely a foundation and makeup product that I underestimated, and for that, I'm sorry. Another kiss. Ugh, and no transfer. Can you believe this? Colored rain. Thank you again. All right, next product. Alrighty, speaking of complexion products that I severely underestimated, let's talk about the e.l.f. Putty Primer. I currently have the e.l.f. Luminous Putty Primer, but I've also tried the original, so I can speak to multiple formulas, and they're both great. So the reason I underestimated these primers so much is because a year ago, I was so anti-primer, you couldn't even talk to me about primer before. I was like, no, 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 don't talk to me about primer. I don't want to talk about primer anymore because I was just very negative towards primer. I had never used one that actually did anything before. I've used e.l.f. primers before that I didn't think did anything. I used their e.l.f. hydrating primer, you know, the one that comes in the blue tube, and I hated it. It was so slippy. It just felt like putting pure silicone on your face, and the foundation just slid around on top of it, and it was like, no, no, no. And I had tried other more high-end ones in the past. I just never felt like a primer ever actually did anything for my skin. Now cue the e.l.f. Putty Primer, who does everything for my skin. I actually tried this for the first time because a bunch of you guys, my subscribers, had been telling me how good the e.l.f. Putty Primer was, because you guys heard me spewing all of this nonsense about how primers were a scam and they don't really work, and you guys were so sweet. You were like, hey, I think you might like the e.l.f. Putty Primer. Why don't you give it a try? And I was like, ugh, fine, okay, I'll give it a try since you guys keep saying it, and also it's not that expensive, so okay. And boy oh boy, am I not eternally grateful for you guys telling me to try this primer, because it's so good. Oh my gosh, I didn't know primers could fill pores. I mean, I knew they had claimed to fill pores. I knew that was a big claim of a lot of primers, but I had never seen them actually do it. And the e.l.f. Putty Primer actually fills your pores. Like, it's amazing, it's wonderful, it's beautiful, it fills your pores, but it doesn't make me break out somehow. I mean, it's freaking sorcery in this product. I actually know they just came out with a new one that's supposed to be an acne fighting putty primer. It's green, and supposedly it has like acne fighting ingredients in it. I think it might have salicylic acid in it. I probably won't get the acne fighting one just because I am very fortunate to not deal with a whole ton of acne, and I really love the luminous one. I didn't think I did at first because I thought that, you know, it definitely does have some shimmer to it. It is a little scary when you first see it. It does have some shimmer to it, but I don't think you see it on the skin at all. I mean, I'm not wearing any highlighter today. I'm just wearing a glowy blush, but I don't really think that you can see any glitter particles. I mean, you guys tell me, can you see any glitter particles on my skin? I don't think so. So I feel like, you know, despite this definitely having some visible shimmer in it, there's no big chunks or anything, and it kind of just rubs out and makes your skin look super luminous and beautiful. So I love that about it. I'm also wearing this on my eyes today. I've been using this as an eye primer for the last week, and I'm in love. It's so, so good as an eye primer. I was afraid it would make my eyeshadows just like get sticky and not blend out at all. Well, spoiler alert, they blend out beautifully with this. I know they sell separate like tiny putty primers that are supposed to be specifically eye putty primers, and I'm gonna go out on a limb here and tell you that I think that might be a little bit of a scam, because this works really well in the eyes too. Now, I'm sure it's good, and you know, it's probably convenient for travel. Not everybody wants to buy like a big thing for an eye primer. I use it as an eye and face primer, but I don't know if you necessarily need like the smaller one. I know it comes in different shades too, so you know what, I'm rationalizing it, and maybe it's not a scam, and maybe I'll try it in the future. I don't know. You guys let me know if you've tried the e.l.f. eye putty primer specifically, and if they're any different than the putty face primer, because I am open to it. But the e.l.f. Putty Face Primer is definitely a makeup product that I underestimated. All right, you guys, and with that, we have reached the end of the video. Those are all of the makeup products that I have severely underestimated, and I am so sorry to all of you. I'm so happy to have you all in my collection here today. I'm so happy that something pulled me to you, even though I, in my head, was like, no, 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 not sure if I'll be interested in. The universe had other plans. They brought us together, and I'm so happy we're all here together today. Oh my gosh. I have so many more products I could talk about that I have also underestimated, so if you like this video, let me know, and I could do another one. I also have a lot of products that I overestimated and end up disappointing me, so definitely let me know if you would be interested in seeing a video like that. I do have a bunch of videos on my channel talking about makeup I changed my mind about, makeup I expected to love more, makeup I outgrew, things of that nature. It's a makeup commentary channel, you guys. I do reviews, I do anti-hauls, but mostly I run my mouth about makeup and I do a lot of makeup commentary. So if that's something you're interested in, I would love to have you subscribe. Oh my gosh, that would be so sweet. I literally would just scream and shout. I do scream and shout with every new subscriber. I just let out a giant scream and my boyfriend runs in and goes, "What's happening?" And I go, "I got a new subscriber." So I really do appreciate when you guys subscribe. Thank you so much. And check out my description box for all of the makeup on my face today in case you're curious, as well as a bunch of Black Lives Matter resources, resources to support the Asian American community, and resources to support the LGBTQ+ community. So please check out those links in my description box if you haven't yet. And I thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye, 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 bye. Ooh, we're doing all my fun gestures at the end of the video. If you watch to the end of the video, you get to watch me embarrass myself. Okay, bye.